On this video, I'm going to talk about a program that I use to map out all of our vacations and trips, and even ones that we haven't even gone on yet. Stay tuned and keep watching.
I'm Bill.
I'm Kelly.
And this is our
adventures.
Here we go.
I was going to do this for our 2 Cent Tuesday, but I figured out that it may be a little longer than what I wanted for a 2 Cent Tuesday, so I decided to do this for our Friday video. This is a program that I use, and there's even apps for Android and Apple, but it's called Road Trippers. I plan out all our trips on this. I just like how it acts and does, and you can take as many trips as you want. And even on trips that we haven't gone on yet, I also have those saved. Because I don't know if you're like me, but I'll see some place, I'll be like, oh wow, you know, if we go out towards Yellowstone, that place would be something that I would want to go see. Or if we end up going to Alaska, then that would be a place that I would want to see. Because when you're watching YouTube and you're seeing all these different places that people are going, you find things that you really like. Well, with this Road Trippers, you can plan a trip and you can go on it whenever and it stays in there. What I like to do is, like, eventually one day we're going to go to Yellowstone and go out kind of out that way. So I have a trip that's called Yellowstone. And every time I see a place that I like out there, I go and put it in there and add it. Doesn't mean that we're actually going to stop there or end up doing it. So then when you're ready to plan that trip, I don't know if this is how I used to be, was I would be like, you know, I saw a YouTube video about this place and it looked really cool and I know it was out there and I can't remember the name of it, and you wouldn't write it down or you forget it, or, you know, if you wrote it down and then you done lost the piece of paper, this saves it in the actual program so you never lose it. And it'll always be there for you when you get ready to go on that trip. Like I said, whenever we talk about a trip, and like I have no clue when we're going to Alaska. I have no idea when, but I have an Alaska trip in there. And every time I see something that I like from another video, I pin it in there. Doesn't mean that we're going there. Like I said, doesn't mean that we're going there, but I know that it's in there. And then when we are ready, I'll have all these places pinned, and then I can go through and filter them out, the ones that we will have time for and that we won't have time for. So that's how I like to use this app. But it's called Road Trippers. You can do a free version, and I believe it's 8 waypoints is what it's called. You can do 8 waypoints in a trip, but that's the max that you can do with the free version. Now, there's a paid pro version, and it's only $30 a year. It's $29.99 a year. That's, to me, for $29, it is the best app there is. And it'll show you how long it's going to take you and where you're going to stop, and you can rearrange your trip. But I have trips that are on. You have like trips and you can make each section. I don't have a ton of them on here. I've got like the Charleston trip. I have the Yellowstone National Parks trip. That's like when we go out west and I want to do some of that. I have the Alaska trip saved on here. I have our Colorado trip that we did a few years ago. It's saved on here with all the stuff. And then when we went to Fort Mountain, I saved it. The cool thing about this is when you click on a trip, I'm going to click on my Yellowstone trip. It pulls it up, and you can put in here, I'm not going to go in detail to how to use the app, the things that's possible with the app. You do your starting point, you do your ending point, pick places on the way that you want to add. You can rearrange them super easy. You can just pick it up and move them around. You can turn things off, like if you decided, okay, you might not want that one, you can just turn those and it will not add it to your list, because like I've got that one. Let's see, what do I have down here turned off? oh, the Great Sand Dunes National Park. I don't know why I had it turned off, but I had turned it off. How much time it's going to take you to do the whole route and trip. It tells you how many miles you're going to drive, and it even gives you how much it may cost in gas. Now, down here at the bottom, there is a little section. You can slide this, and you can tell it to show, like, when you zoom in, you can tell it to show you stuff that's within so many miles of your route. It's going to show, like, the average a little around, but see, then you see the pink area. What things could be close within, I have it set for 30 miles off of our route. But you can, to add anything, all you do is you just click on it and you tell it to add it to your trip, and it'll add it into the right spot of your trip so that it's not out of the way or anything. So it, like, it'll route everything for you. You can add campgrounds in here. You can add places you want to eat in here. You can do attractions, culture, hotel reservations, campgrounds, food and drink, outdoor and recreation, points of interest, camping and RV, and entertainment and nightlife. You can do sporting events, shopping, services, but you can look up all that stuff. And if you just want to find something, you just type it up in the search bar. You find it, you click on it, and then you can add it to your trip. You can even do, like, reviews. If something you've already gone to, you can do a review on it, so you'll know if you want to go there again. When you pay for the $29.99 a year, you get 150 stops. So you can do a trip up to 150 stops on your trips. There's no ads. There's offline maps. You can do collaborations with other people. So, like, if you want to share your trip with somebody, maybe they're going on it with you and everybody wants to do it together, you can do that with this. And it also even shows you live traffic, because you can actually, it has a mobile app and you can just click on it. I've used this, but I have not used the mobile app, I have to honestly say. But you can use it on your phone, and it can route you. We just use our GPS in our vehicles, so I don't use that part of it. But that is an option if you want to use that. You can add a note. You can set dates. Like, if you have somewhere that you want to be at certain dates, let me go pull up my Colorado trip, and I'll show you. Because my Colorado trip, it's got all the dates and stuff. Let's see. So here's my Colorado trip that I had. You can see I have the dates that we were leaving, the dates that we were going to be at certain points. We can find campgrounds around certain areas, like if you know this is how far you want to drive, and everything. That's how we did on our Colorado trip. I added dates to everything, and then it would tell you how long thing. And it just, like, does a little route. I mean, it completely routes it for you, which is really nice. It says that it has 8 million points of interest that you can add into your trip. When you're far out, it kind of shows you your basic, like, areas and things to do. But the further you zoom in, the more it shows you of things to do around a certain area. And that's what I like about it, is because if you're going to an area, you can zoom into that area and see what there is to do around there. Because you can click and just say, okay, I just want outdoor recreation. That's all I want. And it will show you everything that is outdoors. And you can see over here to the left, it has, like, the Cave of the Winds. You can click on that, and it'll take you and show you what other people rated those attractions, or what they're... You can look at the days that it's open. You can get how, if it's pricey or if it's not pricey. And then it just has, like, little a little bio that tells you about the place that you've clicked on. I've just really enjoyed this Road Trippers. I thought that maybe right now everybody's starting to plan their trips and everything, and I wanted to share this with y'all. And I didn't want to do it on a 2 Cent Tuesday because I felt like this was a little more in depth. Not that I went, like, crazy in depth in it, because it's pretty self-explanatory when you start adding stuff and doing things to it. But I wanted to talk about it a little bit more, about how we used this and how much we enjoyed this Road Trippers. I've been doing it, like, this 4 years, because before we made that trip to Colorado, that's when I started using them. That was the first time. But what we like about this is I can start trips anything I want and then add that in there and then keep adding to that trip until you get ready to go, because it'll stay in here forever. As long as you leave it in there, it'll be in there and it won't delete. And the cool thing is if you add a review to this, you can look and see, and there are other people have reviewed their reviews as well. But it kind of let you know what to do. Because like there's one here that talks about this Cave of the Winds. It said, it's pretty neat. I suggest you do the lantern tour. They bring you deeper in the cave and you actually get to your own lantern like an old explorer. And then somebody else put, it's okay, nothing extra special. We didn't discover the tour with our kids, and it was the discovery tour with the kids, and it was worth seeing, but not worth repeating. So you can kind of know if that's maybe something that you want to try or explore more to see if you want to look at more stuff. They also have on here some trip guides. So you can look the trip guide to the Mesa Verde National Park. It's got 10 places pinned in it. So you can click on that. Like if you think you were going to the Mesa Verde National Park, and it'll have a map that pinned what you should see there. So that, I think that is pretty cool as well, because then they kind of done a little bit of the work for you. But they have pre-planned out trips even in here to kind of get you started if you wanted to go to a certain place. But that's, you've got the trip guides. This is National Parks, Trips, and Tips. It has Explore Hidden Gems, British Columbia Rockies, Nova Scotia. You got Camping and Road Trips, Weird. It's got Weird Guides, The Ultimate Offbeat Guide to Chicago, Illinois. So it has like stuff that's offbeat and weird that you would do in that area. Then it has a family road trip. I mean, they have like a lot of them already kind of pinned stuff. I guess the biggest thing that I like about it is, one, it maps it for you. You can rearrange it easy. You can add it. You can share it to somebody. If you're going on a trip and you want people to know where you're at on certain days, you can share them your trip plan so that they know kind of where you're going to be. And then, like I said, you can even put trips in here that you haven't gone on or you're not even knowing when you're going to go on, and go ahead and start pinning some interesting places that you want to add. Thank you to all our new subscribers. I was looking the other day, and in the last 12 months, we have gained 745 subscribers. Thank you, and welcome to all our new family. I've loved getting to meet all y'all, and I love it when y'all comment. So please hit that like button and subscribe if you're not already, as we have a lot of good stuff coming up. But for our 1,000 subscriber video, that hopefully will be out in a few weeks, if you'll subscribe, we can get there. I've got these stickers that I made that I'm going to be giving away. I have 3 cups that we're going to be giving away as well. So keep watching for those. I've only had this past 2 Cent Tuesday, which was about my pillow and the Layla pillow. I love that pillow. It is so nice. So I hope that if you're looking for a pillow, that would be help you decide what one you would want. And till next time, like and subscribe.